Okay, so later po, mga tugang, this program will be aired live over DZGB Eternity. Onde na ba tayo? We are live over DZGB, sorry. Good morning po sa listeners kan DZGB and sa tuyang Facebook Live. Good morning po sa Sendoga Boss. And Attorney Tin, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of our beloved Bishop of Legazpi. We have Bishop Joel Bailon.
Yes, yeah, okay. VP, good morning, Bishop Bailon. Mm. And of course, we also have here Honorable our Councilor JP Lee. Good morning.
Councilor JP Lee, and we have Councilor Ato Valladolid of the Sangguniang Panlunsod of Legazpi. And of course, Tabi Attorney Tin, nailing ko na si Father June Marquez. Yung naman kasubago.
Yes, good morning, Father June Marquez. Yeah,
siya po ang ma-bless kan sa tuyang aktividad ngunya na pag-aaga. And of course, we have Father Momoy Boromayo, our partner in environmental program. Di ba? Magkaklase ang duwang yan.
Oh.
Kaya, gari, pwedeng magkaparihong edad kan duwa. Ano, Padre?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah. And of course, ang pinaka enot pala ng attorney na nag-abot mo niya na aga is si punong barangay
Armando Toledo.
Hayan si Kapitan, yan, si Kapitan Toledo ng barangay Bugtong.
Wow, early birds.
Good morning, Tabi.
Good morning,
and of course, si Congressman Didi Cabrero kanina, nandito na din, mga 8:30 in the morning.
Oh.
Alas 8:30, Congressman Didi Cabrero.
Yon lang sa palibot. Ang aga nila, Opo. Cap, and ni Congressman. Excited na rin talaga, VP Hen, for our Earth Forum and the Expo.
Of course. And we have Attorney Tin, Assistant Regional Director, Ferchito Avilino of the Department of Health.
Yan. Good morning, sir.
Yan, barkada tayo yan. And of course, nailing ko si Kuya Joe San Jose, saroyan sa mga advocates sa agriculture. Bid-bid mo si Kuya Joe, yon sa likod, kataning ni News Manager Marty La Cruz. And of course, Attorney Tin, i-welcome ta po yung mga yaon digdin na mga bisita ta, hali sa ibang mga barangay.
Yes, good morning po, mga barangay officials, our barangay officials.
Yeah, and of course, we would like to announce the arrival of our Honorable Governor, Noel E. Rosal. Governor Rosal is here, mga tugang. And of course, pag yaon si Gob, maybe later, Mayor G. Rosal will be coming. Yan, di ba?
Yes, talagang nag-aarabot na ang satuyang honorable guests, VP Hen. So, in just a few, pwede na kitang magpuan sa satuyang Earth Forum and Expo.
Opo. And of course, nailing ko sa satuyang OIC Provincial Agriculturist Kanalbay, si Madam Bilodo, Rose Bilodo. Yan, yan po
si Jan.
Thank you, Madam. Thank you so much po. Kadakul niyang mga plano about agriculture in the province of Albay. Okay, so this is Earth Forum, mga tugang, broadcasting live from Ayala Malls, Legazpi City.
Yes, anong nga ni ang ibig sabihin ta VPN kang Earth?
Ang Earth is, anong nga ni is meaning? Letter E is environment.
Yes, yan. And letter A is agriculture.
Yan. R is resiliency.
T is tourism.
And H is health. That's why yaon dyan si Assistant Director Avilino.
Yes, yeah. Complete package na, VP, complete ang satuyang Forum and Expo for today.
Opo. Siguro halatalaton ta na mag-alaog po si Congress, si Mayor G. Rosal, tabi ko niya na pag-aga. Mga tugang, and siguro pwede kita magpuon kan sa tuyang programa, ngunyan tabi nal daw. And also, we would like to acknowledge our PBN officers, Tabi Attorney Tin.
Yes, of course, VP Hen. This event would not be possible without our PBN officers. We have our Executive Vice President of PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated, EVP Glenn Barcelon.
And we have our Network President, Ma'am Brenda Bayona Luxin. Yan. Excited si Ma'am sa ika-64th founding anniversary kang DZGB.
Yes, VP. Actually, this is in celebration with our 64th anniversary.
Yes, yes. Okay. So, nalingan po lang si Kapitan Baltasar. Uni, sa likod ni Ma'am Rose. Si Punong Barangay Baltasar ng Barangay 12. Tama, ano? Barangay 12. Yeah. Ah, 13. Hindi patakas sa 12. Barangay 13. Sige po. And later, gabos po ng mga bisita ta digdi. Ma-recognize ta. And ang satuya tabi, mga tugang na mga bisita, ngunyan tabi ngal daw, diri po sa DZGB. Okay? Si Mayor G. Rosal po will be coming in a while. Nandito na, paspaglaog na po si Mayor G. mga tugang sa tuya tabing activity center sa Ayala Malls, Legazpi. Okay,
Attorney? In just a few, we will be starting our festivities. So, good morning once again, everyone. Sa mga wala po dito sa mall ngayon, sa Ayala Malls, Legazpi, maray na pagkaaga sa mga naka-tune in sa Tuya VP Hen sa 7 to 9 kilohertz. And also, we are live sa Samuyang Facebook page na DZGB News Online and sa Samuyang YouTube channel, DZGB Legazpi, and also via TuneIn app.
Opo. Siguro sa task kita, Attorney Tinan, balong talo na magsagat digdi kung bagay mangyari sa stage, ano, while we are preparing our program. Mga tugang, ngunyan, tabing aga, thank you so much po sa gabos nindong presensya. This is a four-day activity hanggang po kitang Sabado, okay? Siguro, Attorney Tin, bago kita magpuni, run down tamo na sa mga partner and sponsors ta, ngunyan na pagkaaga. Ano? We have the provincial government of Albay, headed by Governor Noel E. Rosal. And of course, we have the city government of Legazpi, headed by Mayor Geraldine Rosal.
We also have the Energy Development Corporation and 3rd District Representative Fernando Didi Cabredo.
Okay, we have the Ayala Malls Legazpi as our partner, Department of Tourism Region 5.
Good Found Cement Factory, Legazpi City Fiesta Committee Chairman, Councilor Al Barizo.
Aral Musika at Lampara, our sound system.
LCC Food Garden.
LCC Concourse.
And Blue Blossoms Travelers House.
Yun, Robert James Exhibit Masters Corporation.
J. Charex Food Products and Catering Services.
Liga ng Mga Barangay, Legazpi Chapter.
Department of Health Center for Health Development, Bicol.
Globe Telecom, Ayala.
J2K Manpower and Allied Services.
And Pitmaster Foundation.
And of course, VPN, we also have our exhibitors. Nandito lang din po sila sa Ayala Malls Activity Center. We have DOH Region 5, number 1, booth number 1, and booth number 5.
Yan. Of course, before we proceed with the next announcement, we would like to acknowledge the arrival of Mayor Geraldine Rosal of Legazpi City.
Good morning, yeah.
Mayor G. Good morning po.
Ever gorgeous Mayor
siya po ang
G. Kwan,
Rosal. Siyang first love ni Mayor Noel Rosal. Siyang first love. Siguro, nang tag-uulo ka.
First love. Dayo ko makarelate mga araw
Okay. Alright. Okay. Mga tugang, sagiraray po. Maray na aga Legazpi. Welcome you all to the opening ceremonies of PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated First Ever Earth Forum and Expo today here at Activity Center Ayala Malls, Legazpi. This environment, agriculture, resiliency, tourism, and health is a four-day gathering of environmental and health advocates, faith communities, local government leaders, government agencies, and private institutions to discuss and promote sustainable development and climate change adaptation as we face the new normal in this time of COVID-19 pandemic. May we request everyone to proceed to the gate, to the entrance of our activity center para po mga tugang sa to formally start our blessing ceremonies this afternoon.
To formally start our festivities, ladies and gentlemen, Reverend Father June Barquez will lead us for the blessing ceremony to be followed by the ribbon cutting ceremony. Joining our celebration are Mrs. Brenda Bayona Locsin, PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated President, Mr. Glenn J. Barcelon, PBN Incorporated Executive Vice President, DZGBAM, Concurrent Station Manager and Earth Forum and Expo Overall Project Director, Mr. Henry A. Maceda, PBN Incorporated and Vice President for Programming, Albay Governor Noel E. Rosal, Legazpi City Mayor Carmen Geraldine Rosal, Reverend Father Efren Momoy Borromeo, Diocese of Legazpi Bishop Most Reverend Joel Z. Bailon, D.D., Albay 3rd District Representative Fernando D.D. Cabredo, DOH CHG Bicol Assistant Regional Director Dr. Ferchito Avellino.
Ladies and gentlemen, the ceremonial ribbon cutting with Mayor Rosal and company. You may proceed po with the cutting of ribbon, please. All right. Have a big hand po. Thank you so much, Governor Rosal, Mayor J. Rosal, Congressman Didi Cabredo, Bishop Joel Bailon, and Ma'am Brenda Luxin, and the rest of the group. Didi po sa satuyang ribbon cutting. And now we have the blessing of our activity to be presided by Father John Barquez.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. May the Lord, who went about doing good, be with you all. Brothers and sisters, God is love. In the desire to make us share in this love, He sent His Son into the world to come to our aid and in gentle kindness to help those who were weak, sick, and unfortunate. In His great love for all of us, Christ said that whatever we do to the least among us, we do for Him. He called those who show mercy blessed of His Father and promised them eternal life. Now, Christ the Lord bore our infirmities and endured our sufferings. He went about doing good, leaving us an example to follow. Having Christ's charity as the foundation of all we do, let us now pray to Him, saying, Lord, teach us to serve our sisters and brothers. Lord, for our sake, you were poor and came not to be served but to serve. Grant that we too may love our brothers and sisters and help them in their need, we pray. Teach us to serve our sisters and brothers. By your redeeming work, you made a new world where we have become neighbors to each other and are enabled to love one another. Grant that we too may strive toward a way of life in keeping with the gospel, we pray. You want all people to share in the blessings you have brought. You steer the hearts of many among your people so that, moved by your love, they may gladly devote themselves to assisting those in need and in misfortune, we pray. You will that your mother should also be our mother. Grant that whenever we turn to her for protection, we will find in her a helper sent to us from heaven. This we pray. Our brothers and sisters, let us pray that God, who is love, will enkindle our hearts with the fire of the Holy Spirit, to give us an ardent love for others like Christ's love for us. Let us pray. Blessed are you, Lord God of mercy, who through your Son gave us a marvelous example of charity and the great commandment of love for one another. Send down your blessings on this Earth Forum and Expo so that your servants who generously devote themselves to helping others when they are called on in times of need, let them faithfully serve you in their neighbor. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Alright, para po naman mga tugang sa mga nakadangog mo niyan sa radyo, sa tuyang Facebook Live, nag-iikot po si Father June Barquez and the rest of the company para po sa blessings kang mga booth exhibits dito po sa Ayala Malls Legazpi. And kasabay niya po dyan ang Samoyang Executive Vice President Glenn Barcelon. Siya po ang overall project head kang Earth Forum. And Governor Rosal, Congressman Didi, Mayor G. Rosal, Councilor Valladid, Councilor JPD, we have Bishop Joel Bailon, and Mayor G. Rosal, and of course, Ma'am Brenda Luxin. After po the blessings, immediately po, we will proceed to the part about to the other part of our program.
Thank you so much, Father June Barquez, for leading our blessing ceremony. Let us please all stand once again.
The love of Christ has gathered us together into one. Let us rejoice and be glad in Him. Let us fear and love the living God and love each other from the depths of our heart. Therefore, when we are together, let us take heed not to be divided in mind. Let there be an end to bitterness and quarrels, an end to strife, and in our midst, be Christ our God. And in company with the blessed, may we see your face in glory, Christ our God, pure and unbounded joy, forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you once again, Father June Barquez. Please remain standing for our opening prayer to be led by Father Momoy Borromeo.
All right, while waiting for the prayer to play, we have a video prayer prepared by Father Momoy. And after which, the Philippine National Anthem will be followed.
Sa ngalan ng Ama, ng Anak, at ng Espiritu Santo. Amen.
Bahala, likha ninyo ang bawat bagay sa mundo. Yumanggit-munti ang bukirin, alat ng dagat at tamis ng hangin. Bathala ang bawat bagay na nagmula sa inyong pala ay may tungkulin sa
Ama naming lahat. Iparamdam mo sa amin na ikaw nga ay kasama namin sa kadiliman ng buhay.
Ang tao, inyong hinugis,
tinataas mo kami sa aming likas na pagkatao at tinawag mo kami kaibigan, anak, na ngayon ay ginagawa mo kamanlilikha.
Talino, naging arang at paamo sa parang, naging kumpit na sumagupa sa karagatan, naging apoy na nagpalaya sa karimlan, sa gabi. kayamanan ng mundong inyong likha at may bahagi rin.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Sinasamahan mo kami sa paglikha ng bagong lupa at langit. Ama, hinihingan mo kami ng Espiritu Santo.
Sila'y nasilaw sa kinang ng kasakiman. Ganit na Diyos ang sinamba. Pinaghahati-hatian po nila ang lupa. Karagatan at himpapawid ngayon may bakod na. Kapwa-tao't hayop may inaagawan ng tahanan. Walang nakaliligtas sa kanilang karahasan. Kaunlaran at kabutihan daw ang kanilang sadya. Subalit ang lumilitaw ay sa
pinapamalas mo ang iyong mukha sa pamamagitan ni Jesus na aninag namin sa bundok. Sa bundok mayon, sa lagaslas ng dagat, sa ihip ng hangin, sa huli ng ibon, lahat ng ninalang ay busilak na nililiwalagan ng daan ng bagong buhay. Sa gitna ng aming pighati, pinapikita mo sa amin ang iyong mukha sa pagiging tao na Isus.
Ako'y hinugis niyo't minahon sa lupa. Ang aking buhay ay dito nagmula. At dito rin inaalam. Itong inyong tagod lupa upang umiral sa mapagsamantala. Panalangin ko'y inyong dingin, Hari nawa.
Pinadala mo sa amin ang Espiritu Santo na walang kupas, walang pag-aalinlangan, na kami ay patuloy na hinihinga ng buhay. Pinaparangalan mo, Ama, ang pagiging bat kamay, paa, bibig at puso kami ni Jesus. Ang bawat isa sa amin, Jesus has, and Jesus has no other feet to walk the earth. Ang bawat isa sa amin, Jesus, Jesus has no other feet to walk the earth. No other feet, no other hands to touch the sick than our hands. No other heart to hold and to show love and care than our hearts na paglikha ng bagong lupa, ng bagong pamumuhay. Ang lahat ng ito ay hiningi namin kasama ng bawat puni ng ibon, lagaslas ng dagat, at ang aming puso na ito ay magiging puso ni Jesus. Walang isinasantabi, walang ginagamit na tao, at anumang nilalang para sa sarili lamang kapakanan. Ang pangangailangan na ang empowerment men ng paglikha is to gather as one, to heal the earth, to heal our common home so that we can build up a new humanity in the tent of Abraham, tent of encounter, tent na pag na kung saan makikita namin at mararamdaman namin na kami nga ay kasama ni Bathala. Kaya bahala na ang lahat. Let God be God in all creation. Amen.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Kayang mag-ibig, Diyos ang sinahalan, alam ng puso sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang pinilang, kuyang ka ng mag-ibig, sa manlulupin, di ka pasisigil, sa nagatang tutong sa simoy at sa langit kong pagaw, ay hinatang tulang awit sa pagkayang minamahal.
Hello. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Parakpakan po niya to ang satuyang mga sadiri. Good morning, Legazpi. Good morning, Ayala Malls. Welcome po sa tuwing aktibidad, ngunyang pong pagkaaga. Good morning, Attorney Teen.
Good morning, VP Hen. And once again, good morning, everyone. Finally, VP Hen, this vision of PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated has turned into reality. And besides, vision with action can actually change the world.
Yes, tayo pong magiging warriors ng ating kapaligiran.
Ha? Yes.
Sabi nga ni sa Bicol, taros sa laman. Taro sa tuulang yung naging prayer ni Father Mumoy Kasabato.
Yes, so...
Ibang-iba.
Thank you so much, Father Mumoy. Yung prayer ni Father Mumoy Boromir.
Thank you po sa sendong presensya ngunyang. Kita po, Gabos, taga-protehir kan sa tuyang kapalibutan. Parakpakan ta po, garay, ang sa tuyang mga sadiri. Alright, mga tugang, aside from our objective of discussing and promoting sustainable development and climate change adaptation as we face the new normal, the Earth Forum in Expo is also inspired by Pope Francis' encyclical on Laudato Si, which calls for our collective action to care for our common home. And of course, and this is one of our major activities for the upcoming 64th founding anniversary of PBN-DZGB. Let us all watch this presentation to get to know more about this event.
On the inspiration by Pope Francis' encyclical on Laudato Si, calling for the collective action of people around the globe to care for our common home, the Earth. DZGB, the pioneer radio station in Bicolanja and the consistent number one radio station in Albay, gave birth the first ever Earth Forum and Expo in celebration of the 64th founding anniversary of DZGBAM. In time for the Legazpi Port District Fiesta, this is a four-day engagement of environmental and health advocates, faith communities, local government leaders, government and private institutions, bringing the best minds to share their insights, best practices and solutions towards a sustainable development as a universal call to action to end poverty, protect the planet, and ensure that by 2030, all people enjoy peace and prosperity now and in the future. The Earth Forum and Expo, showcasing the best products, services, and technological advances and innovations in agriculture, agritourism, best practices and exchange of ideas for climate change adaptation, inspiring Bicolanos engaging in environment, agriculture, resiliency, tourism, and health to improve economic well-being of families and poverty alleviation. The first DZGB. Earth Forum and Expo 2022.
And And now, ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome here on stage to give us her welcome remarks, our model and inspiration, and an environmental, agricultural, resiliency, tourism, and health, or earth advocate, the ever supportive and passionate president of the PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated, Mrs. Brenda Bayona Loxin.
Ginagalangan ng Obispo, Most Reverend Jose Bailon, Governor Noel E. Rosal, Mayor Geraldine Rosal, Congressman Dini Cabredo, DOH Assistant Regional Director, Dr. Percito Avelino, morning po, Energy Development Corp, Corporate Relations Head, Mr. Eduardo Jimenez, and Jolie Hamoralin, and City Councilor JP Lee, Father Momoy Romeo, Father June Barquez, Councilor Ato Villadulid, Councilor Alex Howe, mga city officials, kaiba ang Fiesta Committee, mga barangay captains headed by Councilor Ismael Santillan, mga members of the panel of reactors, iba pang mga bisita, Diyos marahay na aga po sa Indogabos, and welcome to Earth Forum Expo here in Ayala Mall. The Earth Forum and Expo is an initiative of a radio station, DZGB, as part of our advocacies on environment, agriculture, resiliency, tourism, and health, anchored on the theme Sustainable Development in the Light of Laudato Si, Climate Change Adaptation, and COVID-19 Pandemic. This is a four-day gathering of environmental advocates, faith communities, government leaders, government agencies, and private institutions to discuss and promote sustainable development and climate change adaptation, as inspired by Pope Francis' encyclical Laudato Si, which calls for a collective action to care for our common home. We have invited key leaders as speakers and panel of reactors to discuss their insights, thoughts, and experiences on how best to protect our planet Earth. We were surprised that when we attended the International Broadcasting Conference in Amsterdam last month, the buzzword is all about climate change adaptation. And in their compliance, and their compliance is evident in their policies and the way they live. It is for this reason that we have decided to expand our advocacy on agri-aquafare, which we have been doing in partnership with then Mayor Noel Rosal before the COVID-19 pandemic. We wish to express our appreciation to all of you who are present today for responding to our invitation, especially to our beloved Bishop Joel Bailon and Governor Noel Rosal, who will be giving their keynote addresses today. Our panel of reactors are composed of engineers, architects, academe, environmentalists, and other government officials. We have also invited some members of Sangguniang Panglunsod handling the different committees related to this advocacy. We have also invited some members of Sangguniang Panglunsod handling different committees to share their inputs and gain knowledge on this four-day forum for integration in their legislative agenda. We have also with us the punong barangays and punong barangay officials of Legazpi City, whom we all know are frontliners of our government, especially during times of disaster and emergencies. Our Earth Forum is scheduled every 1 o'clock in the afternoon, starting today until Saturday, here in Ayala Mall, Legazpi. To reach a wider audience of our advocacy, this we will carry live on air over DZGB AM and in our social media sites, DZGB News Online, DZGB App, and the YouTube channel. In Laudato Si, Pope Francis criticizes consumerism and irresponsible development, laments environmental degradation and global warming, and calls all people of the world to take swift and unified global action. Hence, this Earth Forum is our simple way to respond to this call. In closing, I will be sharing to you a trailer on the new video documentary of Pope Francis entitled The Letter, A Message of Our Earth, calling on all people to stand together for the future of our planet. This documentary offers a breathtaking wake-up call and humbling reminder of our responsibility as members of the society to come together in solidarity for the greater good of one another and the preservation of our planet. Let us be the change we want to be. Let's come together to care for our common home. Thank you and a pleasant morning to all.
The Vatican releases Pope Francis' wildly anticipated encyclical on the environment.
La naturaleza grita. Ténganse. Ténganse.
Protection climatic. Un manque de la protection de la nature qui pousse aujourd'hui de nos populations à quitter chez nous.
Et perder la terre, la floresta. O grande agronegócio que está chegando aí.
The marine heat waves are causing an unknown amount of death among corals.
I want all the global leaders to do something to stop climate change, because if it's not going to be stopped, it's going to harm our future.
Queridos poetas sociales, porque ustedes son poetas sociales porque tienen la capacidad y el coraje de crear esperanza allí donde solo aparece descarte y exclusión.
Je n'arrive pas à rester tranquille. Parfois, j'ai un esprit qui voyage.
O mundo vai mudar. Porque o que estava encoberto, hoje está sendo descoberto.
Il faut lisser des liens très forts. Et il ne faut jamais romper ce lien.
Eu imagino io.
Que nessuno de nós é un'isola. Siamo tutti bisogno di un ideale.
Onde mai? For him, they must protect the environment.
Try to be the change you want to see in the world.
We arrive as individuals with very different stories, but we all shared a dream.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Brenda Bayona Locsin, our gorgeous president, president, ladies and gentlemen of PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated.
Thank you so much, Ma'am. This event will not be possible without the help and support of the city government of Legazpi, together with the Legazpi City Port District Fiesta Committee. Please us now welcome on stage the very supportive local chief executive of Legazpi, Honorable Mayor Carmen Geraldine Rosal, for her welcome message from the city government of Legazpi.
Thank you very much, Mr. Henry Maceda and attorney. To Ma'am Brenda Luxin, the president of PBN. Of course, His Excellency Bishop Joel Bailon, Governor Noel Rosal, Congressman Didi Cabredo, all other distinguished guests, our punong barangays present this morning, sagabos po na yaon, Diyos maray na aga po. I am proud and honored to be part of this gathering of environmental and health advocates, faith communities, local government leaders and agencies, private institutions that have joined together to achieve a common goal, to care for our common home. According to Aldo Leopold, conservation is a state of harmony between man and land. Harmony with land is like harmony with a friend, where you cannot cherish his right hand and chop on his left. In this 4-day Earth Expo and Forum, we are in state harmony with our common home and the earth. Today, we are led to value of taking care of the home, where all nations and its people are all residing, so to speak. This gathering is significant, for it will enlighten and guide our way of understanding how our lifestyle is affecting the earth that we inhabit. This value needs to motivate us on how to guard our healthy earth. This will perhaps awaken our conscience by finding out the state of the environment, the state of agriculture, the state of tourism, and the state of health of the earth where we live in. The timeliness of this gathering, where it will focus on discussing and promoting sustainable development and climate change adaptation while facing the aftermath of the COVID-19 pandemic crisis called New Normal, must be considered a strategic action. All of life is interconnected. Life here on Earth is interconnected. And I'm highly pleased of the purpose of this Earth Expo, where it's aimed to come up with a concerted movement on how to help prevent the next pandemic by transforming our relationship with nature, particularly on environment, agriculture, tourism, and most importantly, on the Earth's well-being, its health. I therefore congratulate DZGB AM, PBN, radio station, through the leadership, of course, our EVP, Glenn Barcelon, and our VP for programming, Mr. Henry Maceda, and all other men and women of DZGB, PBN. And I also would like to congratulate the station on its 64th founding anniversary for its notable achievement in the field of broadcast journalism since its inception of bringing the radio airwaves in 1958. The marching order of caring for our home, the earth, is heatedly declared by Pope Francis in his second encyclical letter called Laudato Si. Let this call to save our world by Pope Francis be the center of the significant gathering on the forum of coming out with plan for good and benefit of the future for our beloved Earth. Putting resiliency at its center, a trait that we need to perpetuate with vigor and vitality. With this, again, congratulations po, Ma'am Brenda, and to the whole men and women of PBN, and congratulations to this very inspiring program activity that you have this morning. God bless po sa Togawas.
Thank you so much, Mayor Carmen Geraldine Rosal. And now to award the Certificate of Appreciation and Token, let us please call up the stage our Executive Vice President, Glenn Barcelon, and our President, Ma'am Brenda Loxin, and of course, together with our Vice President, Henry Maceda.
Yan po mga tugang na token sa tuyang mga speakers ngayon is environment-friendly po yan. Ma'am Brenda, Bayona Loxin, yung pong naghanap ka anduman sa Manila Attorney Team para hanapon saan mga environmental-friendly token sa tuyang mga speakers. Ngunyan na daw.
Yes, dapat din naman talaga na piga-advocate na VPN ang environment-friendly na sa tuyang mga tigagamit.
Yeah po. Thank you so much, Mayor G. Rosal, AVP Glenn Barcelon, and Ma'am Brenda Bayona Loxin. At this point, I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Engineer Martin Reynoso. Engineer, thank you so much. And of course, ang samuya pong station manager kan OKFM, the ever-charming Mr. Sugar Asukar. Ayan, hindi ka makabalos. Alright. Mga tugang, this Earth Forum and Expo is inspired by Pope Francis' encyclical on Laudato Si, which calls for our collective action to care for our common home. In Laudato Si, Pope Francis critics consumerism and responsible development, laments environmental degradation and global warming, and calls for people to the world to take swift and unified global action. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome and lean our ears to our keynote speaker to shed light on this concept. The very own Bishop of the Diocese of Legazpi, Mga Tugang, Most Reverend Joel Z. Bailon.
Diyos maray na aldo po sa sindo gabos, Mga Tugang. Sa tuyong ginagalangan ng mga pamayokan sa probinsya, as in siyudad, Governor Noel Rosal, Congressman Didi Cabrero, Mayor G, as in ang sa iyang council sa siyudad, Ma'am Brenda, as in ang sa iyang family sa DZGB, etc. Mga Tugang ko sa pagkapadi, Father June, Father Mumoy, as in kung sisay pa, at sa sendo po gabos Mga Tugang na may pagmakulog sa satuyang Mother Earth sa kinaban na itinaw sa tuokan mahal na Diyos. Diyos Marina Aldo po, sa sendo gabos, giraray. Thank you, Sir Henry, Attorney. Thank you po sa sendong presensya ng niya na Aldao. As in, gusto ko lang po, if I may, I just would like to be very simple with this sharing that I am going to give this morning. So there are three things tangani na madali tang kaputan, and I'm basing my reflections actually on the ever famous, now very familiar encyclical letter of our Holy Father Pope Francis, the Pope Francis, which is Laudato Si, which is actually pinaka basis kining Earth Forum niya tong iningon niyan. And this was written in 2015, 2 years after he became Pope. This was his second encyclical, if I am not mistaken. And indeed, it touches very much the very core of our concern for Mother Earth. Kaya ano po ang pagsasabi digdi, as in paano niya ito masisimbagan ining katotohanan ini. There are three things that I would like to share with you. Simply, the reality, the problem, and the solution. Ini po, sa kuya lang na paghiling, as in sa perspektibo kan Laudato Si. So I begin with the reality, and I start with this quotation precisely at the very start of Laudato Si, when the Holy Father says this, and I quote, Laudato Si, mi Signore, praise be to you, my Lord. In the words of this beautiful canticle, Saint Francis of Assisi reminds us that our common home is like a sister with whom we share our life, and a beautiful mother who opens her arms to embrace us. This sister now cries out to us because of the harm we have inflicted on her. The earth herself, burdened and laid waste, is among the most abandoned and maltreated of our poor. She groans in travail, quoting a scriptural phrase, we have forgotten that we ourselves are dust of the earth. Our very bodies are made up of her elements. We breathe her air, and we receive life and refreshment from her waters. I would like to enter into dialogue with all people about our common home. Unquote. So, yung pinian introductory statement kan sa tuyang Pope Francis, and here he already manifests or expresses a deep concern for what is happening in our world today. And indeed, sisa isa sa tuya ang day nakakaaram o day nakakasabot more or less kaining problemang ini. Climate change, global warming, deforestation, mga tataramo na familiar sa satuya na maray. Yaon naman po dyan itong mga bagyong nagkukusog, bulkan na nagsasabog, linog na nagdadaranin distroso sa itong buhay. And we don't have to go very far. Digdi po sa satuya, sa palibot, I just would like to invite you to look at the reality that is here in our midst. Floods all around, muddy waters, dyan sa Lapu-Lapu, sa Tula-Tula, baya, ayun po, patidig din sa Lapu-Lapu. Basta nag-uuran, lalong-lalo ng pirang aldaw yan, as in mga makusugo na maray, minabaha tulos. Pero bako lang pong baha, aram nindo yan. Baha na may dugi. Baha na muddy, brown. Considering, bako na lang sutubig ang nagbabahali sa uran, hali sa langit, kundi sutubig pagbagsak sa daga, daradara ang daga. As in yun ang nagiging baha sa satuya. And pag marakan tubig, nawalat duman sa dugi, aram ta po yan. And that is a truth that we all are familiar with. Irresponsible mining. As simple case is itong Minas Arapurapo, nakaito, there was a time, nagkaigwa ng fiscal duman. Kaya nagkaigwa kita ng mass action to protest precisely the way mining was being done irresponsibly. And this is not only happening here, aram ta po yan dyan, sa kadakol na lugar nagdi sa Pilipinas, yun ini ang nagrangay, lalong-lalo na kan mga katutubo, mga tugang niya to indigenous communities who have owned the land from generations far away from them from this present time and are now being deprived of what is theirs. Simply because, yaon dyan itong development daa. And it is interesting that this is the title of our forum today, Sustainable Development. Are we going to sustain mining at the expense of the indigenous peoples? Are we going to sustain mining even when it destroys our environment? Questions that we will need to ask. Waste. Sa satuyang mga seashores and kadagatan, salamat sa Sarong Padi na from the Diocese, Father Ricking Bermas, nakaukod po ako maging scuba diver. As in, nagkakapirang basis na kami dyan, dyan lang mismo, sa Baybayon, Canlegaswi City, digdi. Nangulik na kami nin mga basura sa irarum kandagat. Ito nga ni, dahil nga nito nagpirang oras, pirang kilo ito sunatipon niya mo na mga ati, mga basura, plastic, bote, gabos, yaunduman sa irarum kandagat. Sa inhali ito, sa langit, pinabagsakan mga anghel o sa mga tawong nagkonsumo nin manlain-lain na pagkaon, managbarakal nin mga gamit, asin ngunyan, tadain na ninda kaipuhan, yao na sa irarum kandagat. When I was in Masbate as bishop there, I was there for 11 years, one of the major efforts that we did was something like this. We had also an environmental forum and we invited several speakers from the University of the Philippines. And a couple of things that I remember very well na sinabi ninda, duwang bagay nga niya, ang girumdumo nindo, ang tandaan nindo, na masasabi nindong may problema ang sa tong kapalibutan. Enot, kung maghiling ka ngayon sa bakulod kan mga bulod, yung pinakaitaas na yan, and you see nothing but coconut trees, ang bulod na yan, nagagadana. Yan ang enot na indicator para sa sinda. Hilingon tama ng God po, ang sa tuyang mga bulod, ang sa tong mga hills digdig. What are there on top, duman sa bakulod nito, topmost? Kadaklan, nyog. Salamat sa Diyos na igwapanin mga lugar na aramtam mga kahoy pa and we try our best to protect those trees, endemic trees, trees that are hardwood. That is why we are working closely with government tangani na mapreserve rin mga arog kini. And salamat sa Diyos sa mga tao na naghihingua na mapreserve rin. Pero, sagud sa in, sagud no arin. Ikadwa, indicator, and this is closer to us. Sa mga natadta, pagkakaaga, ano ang mga layog-layog, ano ang mga alitap-tap, ano ang mga alibangbang, ano ang mga butterflies na naglalayog-layog dyan? Anong color? Specifically, puti. Sabi ninda, if that is all the color of butterflies and moths around us, especially in the urban areas, then the environment is dying in that area. Indeed, kung dahil na po nin colorful butterflies sa satuyang tahaw, that is a clear indicator that there is something wrong with us. The beauty of nature is being lost as manifested by this colorless or white moths or butterflies. So, As the Holy Father said, Mother Earth groans in travail. Nag-aagrangay sa pagsakit. Those of you who have been mothers or are mothers know exactly what it means to groan in travail. Sa oras nin pangaki, mientras na nagahalat ka na magluwasan sa imong hinahalat na umboy, yaon dyan itong groaning in travail, the pain of waiting. Pero maray ini, dahil ta, may pigahalat kitang buhay. Ang sa tuyang ina, nag-aagrangay, bako dahil sa buhay na pigahalat niya na magluwas, kundi dahil sa kagadanan na daradara kan sa iyang mga aki, huli sa pagpabaya. So, what is the problem? This is the reality, and what is the problem? I've read one article from a Franciscan theologian who is reflecting on precisely on the way we deal with the world. And sabi niya, the word respect is an important component for our way of relating with the world. Irrespeto tangaya ang kalikasan. But he is asking us to look at the word respect, not only itong igagalang, irrespeto, dahil basta pagpapasiparahon ng pangangaipo, kundi sabi niya, the original meaning of respect is to look a second time. Respect. To speculate. To inspect. To look at a second time. And this is precisely what the Lord is asking us as well in our relationship with Mother Earth. To look at it a second time. Sabi niya, I am afraid our first gaze at anything is always utilitarian. And what is that? It is always almost totally about what I think. What is it in it? What's in it for me? What can I get out of it? How can I make money from it? Does this make me look good? Will this give me pleasure? The reason why we are not able to respect Mother Nature is because we only respect ourselves. We only look at me, myself, the I in this relationship. Kaya, sabi ni Pope Francis sa Laudato Si, ang problema ta is what he calls anthropocentrism. Na ang tao nasa sentro kan kinaban. Kaya ang gabus na bagay takes a relative value before the human person. Kaya, ma-decide ang tao, ining daga na ini para sa kuya ini, ining dagat na ini, aprobitsaran ko ini, ining bagay na ini para sa sako ini. Pirmisa nang para sa sako. And sabi ni Pope Francis, it is the belief that humans are radically separate from the rest of the non-human world and therefore has control over it. Itong the rest of the non-human. Kaya, garubagang, kung anoon mo yako, nasa sa kuya yan. Kung gusto kong rauton ini, nasa sa kuya ni. Sa diri ko man ini. And this, of course, unfortunately happened because we discovered what we call now private property. Sa kuya yan eh. Binakal ko yan eh. Rugaring ko yan eh. Kaya makabuot ako kung anong gusto ko. The Holy Father says, dai pwede. Tanata, kung ipapadagos sa ining attitude na inining anthropocentrism, it develops in us a practical relativism. Meaning to say, we value creation only to the extent that it is useful and valuable to me as a human person. Nagiging gamit ko ang ano paman. As in, ang mabumundo po kayo is when I begin to see my relationship with the non-human world as something useful and practical, this becomes also my relationship with people. I begin to use people as well. And indeed, nababaliktad ang relationship. We love things and use people. Yan ang problema when we develop this anthropocentrism, this attitude of being at the center of the world. Now, the Holy Father in his encyclical invites us to look at the gospel as the original message to correct this attitude. And what is that? The gospel is about the gospel of creation. The very first book of the Bible is the book of Genesis. And it is there that we learn how creation was created, the whole world, the universe. It started with the light, that let there be light, etc. Familiar po kita kayan. Pero sabi nin sa tung Santo Papa, environmental harm is caused by sin. Ito sa pagkasala ni Adan, budak ni Eva, duman sa Hardin Kaniden. But sin as understood as broken relationship with God. When Adam and Eve acknowledged the invitation of the serpent to eat the forbidden fruit, they broke their relationship with God. And when they broke their relationship with God, it also led to broken relationships with one another. Takan pig-confrontar na si Adan, kan mahal na Diyos, ay sabing, sisay nagsabi sa imong huba ka. Ta sabi ni Adan, nagtago ngay ako sa imong kagurang nan, ta huba ako. No, sisay nagsabi sa imong huba ka. Ha, nagkaon ka kan bawal na pruta. Sabi ni Adan, inipaano ng yung babaeng itinaumus ako, tinintaran ako, nagkaon man ako. And if we remember, several verses before this, after God created woman from the rib of the sleeping Adam, ano ang sabi ni Adan pag mata niya, pag muklat niya kan sa iyang mga mata, as inahiling niya si Eva, ano sabi niya? Wow! This at last is flesh from my flesh and bones of my bones. Iyo ini ang pinakamagayon na description na masasabi ni Adan digdi sa babaeng itinaukan Diyos sa iya. Ngunya na nagkaon na sinda and they have broken the relationship with God. Now, Adam says, ini paano ngayang babaeng itinaumus ako, this woman? Come to think of it, this is how we relate with one another. Pag lambing-lambing, romantic, wow, love na love, magayunon ka, pero nag-iriwal na, di mo na nga naimapod by her name or by his name. Ini paanong yung babaeng ini? Yan paanong yung lalaking yan na pirmina sa ng buyong? We have broken relationships precisely because we broke our relationship with God by turning away from our covenant with Him. It also broke our relationship with one another and it has broken our relationship with the world. Kaya anong sabi nin mahal na Diyos kay Adan? Cursed will you be. You will find your food from by the sweat of your brow. Your whatever you plant will bring thorns and thistles. Iyo inian sa imong sintensya. We have broken our relationship with the world because of sin. Sabi kan Santo Papa, ining sin na ini, itong pag-turn away kan tao sa relationship sa Diyos, iyo ini ang pinakadahilan kan sa tuyang misery ngunyan sa kinaaban. Broken in part because humans presumed now to take the place of God. Tinalikudan na ninda ang Diyos, sinda na ang Diyos ngunyan, kita na ang Diyos ngunyan, kaya nakakapagbuot kita kung anong gusto ta. Iyo ini ang problema. Iyo ini ang dahilan kung nata taigwa kita kaining misery na inaagihan sa satong kinaaban ngunyan. Gera, degradation, climate change, global warming, what have you? It is precisely because man thinks that he is at the center of the world. Duman sa book of Genesis, when God created man, ang sabi niya duman, rule and subdue the earth. Yaon yan duman sa Bible. I forget the exact verse. But after God created the human person, man and woman, this is what He told them. Rule and subdue the earth. Ang problema tadaa, misinterpreted da ang gustong sabihin kaini. We have learned to exploit the earth rather than cultivate and care for it. When the Lord said, rule and subdue the earth, It meant cultivate it, make it fruitful and meaningful, and care for it. Ana indadangugan la tao, exploit. Aprobitsare, mintras harani. Magpakasawa ka sa good muya mo. Ayu ini an interpretasyon kan tao, bunga kan sa iyang pagkakasala, asin pagtalikod sa pakikipagtipan sa mahal na Diyos. So that's the problem, and I think it is important for us to see whether we ourselves are truly part of this problem. Ini yung I, the I in me na mahalagang maray. Sagkod na daan sa kuyang pakikipagrelasyon sa kinaban, sa kapwa, tao, lalong-lalo na sa mga pobre, sa mga bagay na bakong tao, sa daga, sa dagat, sa bulod, sa kali, sa salog, manungod lang sa I, ining utilitarian I, itong so, ano ang makukuha ko digdi? Anong mapapakinabangan ko digdi? Anong ganansya na makukuha ko digdi? Matawin ining kaugmahan sa sako? Magiging pogi ako digdi? Mga kahaputan na bunga kan sa tuyang pagiging I sa tahaw kang kinaban. So, what do we need to do? Finally, the third point is the solution. I don't want to sound simplistic in the solution, but the very first thing is for us to recognize that there is no doubt that the world is at the moment undergoing a profound crisis brought about by many natural as well as man-made changes. Man-made changes precisely because of our selfish attitude towards nature. Ito nga ning I, itong anthropocentrism na ito. Action now is needed. But for the Holy Father, Pope Francis, action means more than laws and policy making. We can have all the laws that we can have. We can have all these policies. Pero kung pag-abot kan oras, ako, di man akong pakilabot, whether ining basurang iniyo, madaraning baha, dahil tapig babara ko ang kanal. Kung pag-abot kan oras, apersar kan mga lay na sinusurat kan sa tong gobyerno, as in mga namamayo sa banuaan, pag-abot kan oras, mapalud ako nin kahoy, ta ining narang ini muya kong gibuho na bunsod sa sakong harong. Sa irresponsibleng paagi, because there are responsible ways of cutting trees, then, ang solusyon, tanganing magkaigwanin laws, magkaigwanin mga policy. Sabi ni Pope Francis, daing kamugtakan iyan. And this is also what I believe. That is why my point in this, at this point is, I mean, in my sharing is, I have to begin with myself. For the Holy Father, action means more than laws and policy alone. It must go at get at the roots, at motives, and the capacity to respond to present challenges. And this change must begin in each one of us. Development. This is what we are trying to say. Sustainable development can only happen if we begin from our side. If we maintain our radical egocentricity, ito nga ning I, ako lang pirme, then it is all about us. What we like, what we want, what we think is important. When we can grant respect to seemingly unimportant things, little things, like when we say to a little flower, I bet no human eye will ever look at you except me. And I want to thank God for you. I want to thank you for being there, being that you are, to delight, allowing me to delight in the color that I appreciate in you. I'm meaning to say, ipuin ang respeto, makahiling kaning burak, and again, I'm not saying this in a very simplistic way, but for an example, when we begin to appreciate a flower for what it is, not, ay, pwede ko ining ipabakal, pwede ko ining aprobitsaran na itaw ko sa sakuyang, ano nga, girlfriend o agum, whatever, but simply to appreciate the gift of the flower for being there, as a gift of creation, then I think there is something that is radically changing in us. And this allows us especially to develop a kind of respect in our relationships with one another as human beings. Sabi ni Pope Francis, kung gusto tangayang mag-develop nin tunay na development para sa satuyang Mother Earth, da itapaglingawan na ang development na ni is also a preferential option for the poor. Because oftentimes, when we look at development, it is always, unfortunately, at the expense of the poor, not in on behalf or in behalf of the poor. When we look at development, pupurutulungtan mga kahoy na yan, tamapatindog kita ng mga magagayon na building. Development, haraliun na yan mga paraumang yan, taday man nagbuburungan ng tultulan sa mga uma, magpatindog kitang subdivision dyan, o mall, o kung ano paman. Development at the expense of the poor. Sabi ni Pope Francis, ang tunay na development is also a preferential option for the poor. And therefore, it leads once again to respect, to a re-speculation, a seeing with the new eyes, with a new set of eyes, and a solidarity with all creation, human and non-human. It is a solidarity where all sorrows are shared in the heart of compassionate love. All tears are gathered in the womb of mercy. All pain is healed in the balm of forgiveness and reconciliation. The true human being sees the threads of God's overflowing love that binds together the whole of creation. After all, ang nagtutuhog kay niyang tanganing maging saro, iyo ang paggamot kan Diyos na iyo ang dahilan kung natataanion kita digdigabos in the first place. And we, humans especially, are called to see deeply, to respect deeply, to respect, to look again with a new set of eyes, in order that we may love deeply as well. And in that great love, may we rejoice in the overflowing love of our God. So hali duman sa Diyos, minababa kita, tanganing mahiling taan sa tuyang responsibilidad para sa kada saro, sa pagrespeto kan kada saro, tao man ini ubako. As in sa pagmidbid na kaini, as in pagdevelop ta kan mga karahayan na pwede tanggibuhon, huli kaini yung pagrespeto, then minabalik kita sa awareness na padaba kita kan mahal na Diyos. And that brings about peace and true results in our effort to care for Mother Earth. Ngunyan po, sa integral ecology ining pigahagad sa satuya, na ang satuyang gigibuhon always in reference to our respect for all of creation, let us remember that we are all interconnected. In every part of our daily life, whether it is academics, sports, social relationships, politics, economics, science, arts, etc., gabus ini may connection sa satuyang buhay sa kinaban. As in, kung anuman ang sitwasyon na kinamumugtakan ta, igwa kitang magiginibo dyan, tanganing husayon ta ang satuyang kinaban. Arts, science, politics, religion, gabus kita, igwa kayan. So, sabi ta nga ni, ano ang gibuhon tango niyan? Recycle, reuse, reduce. Ibaga po inyan mga pigsasabi tango niyan sa, kuyan, pag manungod kayo ng Laudato singin ni. Recycle, reuse, redeem, reduce. I would like to summarize it with one word. Return. Come back to me, sabi nin kagurangnan. And I will give you life. Isma Reynaldo po.
Thank you so much, Most Reverend Joel Z. Bailon, D.D., our Bishop of the Diocese of Legazpi. And to award the Certificate of Appreciation and Token, we have our President, Ma'am Brenda Bayona Loxin, together with our Executive Vice President, Sir Glenn J. Barcelon. Wow! Thank you so much once again, Father, Most Reverend Joel Z. Bailon, Bishop Bailon. Thank you so much for enlightening us about Laudato Si, the encyclical written by Pope Francis, and for sharing to us the words of our Father in relation to such. And VP Hen, I have read about the gist of this encyclical written by Pope Francis, which is Laudato Si, and I was amazed how Pope Francis passionately wants to reach out to each one of us to educate and inform us about the current or the state of our common home. And in fact, in that encyclical Laudato Si, Pope Francis described our common home as a sister with whom we share a common bond and a mother who embraces us. So, and yet, what are we doing and giving in return? So let us ponder on that.
Thank you so much, Attorney Tin. And before we proceed with the next key resource speaker for this morning's activity, I'd like to acknowledge first the following Punong Barangay who are present here this morning. Punong Barangay Jose Pispis, EMS Barrio. Kapitan, salamaton pong maray. We have Punong Barangay Jodrico o Barangay 5 Sagmin. We have Punong Barangay Maria Lourdes Baltasar, Ate Malu, thank you so much, Barangay 13, Albay de Siclegaspi. We have Punong Barangay Gerald Aike, Barangay 14, Ilawod. And we have Punong Barangay Nympha Bolaños of Barangay 20, Kabangan. Thank you so much po, Kapitan. We have Punong Barangay Carmen Sarona, Barangay 22, Binanuahan East. And we have Punong Barangay Edwin Espiritu, inong pirming may kwarta, Salapi, Barangay 25, Lapu-Lapu. And we have Punong Barangay Joy Bahoy of Barangay 27. Thank you so much, Cap. We have Punong Barangay Joselito Martinez of Barangay San Roque, Legazpi. Punong Barangay Marife Velasco of Barangay 33, Peñaranda. And we have Punong Barangay Cyril Saiko, Barangay 35, Tinago. Punong Barangay Armando Toledo ng Bugtong. And we have Punong Barangay Silvia Del Agua, Barangay 43, Tamauyan. Punong Barangay Juanita Bea, Barangay 47, Arimbay. And Punong Barangay Albert Asaituno o Barangay Taisan. And Punong Barangay Norberto Abion o Barangay Lamba. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much. Dakulon pa lang kita VP Hena sa tuyang barangay officials who are
so
willing to lend their ears para sa pangangatamanan kan sa tuyang kapalibot.
And so we have to acknowledge the presence of City Tourism Officer Agapita Pacres. Madam, thank you so much for coming.
Good morning, Madam.
Okay.
An sa tuyang aktibidad mo niya na aga, dahil mangyayari kunwara ang tabang, as in suporta kan gobyerno probinsyal kan Albay, urog pa na ang pangataman kan kapalibutan, disaster resiliency, sektor nin agrikultura, turismo, asin salud, ang nasaro sa saindang prioridad na programa para sa mga albayano. Let us welcome ladies and gentlemen on stage, an international speaker on best practices on disaster risk reduction and climate change adoption, LGU perspective, a multi-awarded local chief executive in good governance and transparency, the governor of the province of Albay, Honorable Noel E. Rosal.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Attorney Mary Christine Logabella. Palapakan ta siya, Attorney. And of course, ang lalaking hindi inuumaga, Mr. Henry Maceda. Palapakan po natin. Bishop Joel Bailon, the Bishop of the Diocese of Legazpi, Congressman Didi Cabredo of the 3rd District of Albay. Palapakan ta si Congressman. And of course, the Mayor of Legazpi, Carmen Geraldine Rosal. And representing the Department of Health, we have Assistant Director Chito Abilino. Of course, my two friends, mga advisor ko yan. Palapakan natin si Father Momoy and Father June. No. Pag mga pag low na low ako, nagaparatreksin ni sa kuya. And siyempre, kung meron tayong man of the hour, the woman of the hour, tamara di si Mr. George Bayona, we have Ma'am Brenda. Palapakan tap sa po. And of course, Barangay Captain, multi-awarded. And the Vice President ba of DZGB, Executive Vice President, fresh from Rome. Tiktaram ko, tas pasalubong, dahil ko pa nakresipi. Glenn Barcelon. Siyempre, our barangay officials, salamat sa Indugabos. Aram na nindo yan, ano, kanlas, siyempre si Bishop. And of course, we have also from the provincial government, my new family, yaon digdi ang gusto kay pamidbid sa indo ang maigoson na agriculturist ko duman. Programa pa sa niya na, sa programa pa sa na ni Rose, ubus na ang budget kang probinsya. Para pagkanta po si Rose Belyodo. No? Rose, taga-uwas ka ba o ligaw? Ha? Uwas, kababayan ko talaga ini siya. Saan ka sa uwas? Mayaw. Ako, taga-Saban. And siyempre po, para pagkanta man, from the private sector, we have ang inaanak ko, Martin Reynoso. And siyempre, ang satuyang mga pogi. Mga pogi kan satuyang sanggunian pang lunsod. Puro malo nini. Tayakon sa likod ni Bishop, pero baluwain ni. Pabaluwain ni pag nakaluwas tuman. Lalo na saro digde. So ang apelido do, Jow. Para pagkanta si Alex Hau. Then ang kapitanta, Ato Valladolid. And siyempre, the former president of the Liga ng mga Barangay sa Legazpi, JP Lee. And all the associations, di ko nakamomensyon na ron tabi ng mga yaon, di aram naman nito. Siguro, ang sa kuya i-mention lang siyempre, ang sa kuya ihado na iyo ang presidente mo o chairman kang pastoral, di ba? Ayon si ihado, si Eric, yun, bidango niyan eh. Eric, Sabado, maparapol naman kita. Okay, siyempre po, the men and women of DZGB, para pagkanta siyenda, mauran man o mainit, pero may kairibanan ta. Sa endo tabi, dakula ako na honor kan sa endo. Ay, si Pita Pacres, naaling ko pala, para pagkanta man si Miss Pita, ang satuyang tourism officer. So, mga tugang, dakulong pakimataram. Pero allow me first, of course, to touch sa history kang DZGB. Today, sabi ko nga ni, I feel so elated and honored and privileged to be invited in this big event alongside with the 64th founding anniversary of DZGB AM that was historically founded 64 years ago by George Bayona, who was known for his innovative ideas on radio electronics. Mr. George Bayona could be compared to the late Steve Jobs, di ba? The founder of Apple Incorporated, may bago bang ngayon yan, iPhone 14. Mr. George Bayona was the Steve Jobs of the 60s, while the late Steve Jobs was the George Bayona on the 21st century. Para pakanta si, maski dahil sa ura, digdi po. Dit sa nang pagiyan ta, lalo na ako, may mga kapitan digi inarabot pa ini. Ako na mundag ka sa ako, 70s na. Ano? In 1958, when DZGB AM was founded, was a time when radio communication was still, nakumbaga, in egg state pa, dahil pa lamang, popularly known as Radio Balagon. Yan. According to the old folks, DZGB AM was called Radio Balagon because the radio technicians, workers, at that time had to put long double wires using Aleco's electric force in going to its residence using a rectangularly formed small size and well-burnished box with a tiny speakers placed inside and at the outside was a volume tuner. Saro sana ang tuner, DZGB sana. Many homes in almost all barangays that wanted to listen to DZGB on air had to apply to have their own radio balagon installed. Oh, talagang ang istorya. Making the historic beginning of radio broadcast to be in place in Legazpi City and uninspired not only Legazpi but many parts in Bicol and probably being awarded, palapakan natin ha, nationally for so many times nakikipaglaban ang DZGB. Baka din no aram ha, sa mga national awards sa radio, pero may nagsakat ini si Madam Brenda dahil ang garumabilang ta, no? And onward. Today, we can compare this form of installation to how we want to have cable and internet at home. Now, my topic, ladies and gentlemen, that was 64 years ago. when climate change and the issue on environment were not yet a big and top concern. It was a time when everything looked divinely clean, safe, and not implicated with the effects on the misuse of fossil fuels, where our earth is not complacent. Yun po ang pangaji. So, ratio imperata. I'm so proud. Pag ako nasa Manila, pigi pangaji na ini. Yun po. So, pag-abuso na sinabi ni Bishop. Then, darakulang kumpanya nag-inarabuso. Yun na po ini ang problema ta. Bishop mentioned climate change adaptation and mitigation. Araman sa nindo ang Legazpi Albay is the forefront of this campaign. Kumbaga tuom tayo ni Gabos, but I tell you, as mentioned in the Horatio Imperata, it is a calling, it is a collaboration. Di pwede na concern lang kang gobyerno, di pwede concern lang kang simbahan, it should be the concern of everyone. At present, we are made to correct them. We are made to adapt and review what went wrong. We are made to restrain the devastating effects of the damages made by the climate change and of environment abuse. Today, we are called to alter our moves by the call on how to sustain it at least to its former and original formation. Inis sinabi ni Bishop na last niya, return. Para pagkanta si Bishop, bilib ako. So, inadalan ko, nadala ni Bishop, talagang nasa isip pala ni Bishop. Pero mo yan, nagsabkuhan kami. Pero hindi ko ni Bishop na aram sa tataram niya. Pero kasi mo, nagaparaulok ako sa niya ko, yun talaga sa tataram ko. Di ba? On how it was made to perform like in the past. And most importantly, on how to restore it, di ba? To a new form of development. Baya, di ba? Sabi ko kay Bishop, Papal Francis, sabi nga ni Mayora, Laudato si, which means praise be. Di ba? Laudato si is Pope Francis, the most comprehensive Vatican document ever. Siya pa sana on environmentalism. Because the Pope now thinks that as the highest, di ba? Priest on Mother Earth, he has to contribute. Kaya, grabe. Its arguments, ladies and gentlemen, are founded on theological convictions, which was subtitled On Care of Our Second Home. Now, mga namumutangkong mga Albayanos, we need to work together to patch up and repair it not by prayers alone, but by actual actions. Kaya nga sabi ni Bishop, so prayer baga ni Father Momoy, nagkaroon sa mabay na, pinailing baga sa toya, touching na maray, di ba? Iloon mo ang mga environment, pag di ito pagkakarawan, ilingon mo. So regalo sa tuya, kan mahal na Diyos, giniributang sa diritang kapritso. I have a very intriguing question before I end. Ano ba ang mas importante? Ang infrastruktura na makapag-ibog itang tinampo o ano man na programang naisipta para sa pagpagayon na ang satuyang environment, ang satuyang tubig, ang satuyang mayon, ano man na created by God, ini ang question ko niyan. Ano ba ang pigapuntang farm to market roads? Is it really for the people's welfare? Ini ang mga dapat ta na kita mga opisyales. Yaon po ang simbahan. We are so lucky na nakikisabay sa tuya. Si Father Momoy, suminakat mismo yan sa Binabista. Bako ako ta nag-iintriga. Siya mismo nagduman, suminakat sa Capitol. Tinawan niya akong kopya. Nailing ko sa pandik ni Father Momoy. Sabi niya, Gob, dapat maghiro kita. Bako na kita magpakaraot kay mga tao. Bako ini po, ang importante, Governor, gamitin mo ang sa imong mandato na ini mapundo dahil ini ang gusto kan mga tao. That's why I would like to quote a very good words from Pope Francis in saying, may the relationship between man and nature not be driven by greed to manipulate and exploit but may the divine harmony between beings and creation be conserved in the logic of respect and care. Again, I would like to congratulate DZGB, palapakan tagaralay. Pigbago ninda sa concept. Ini si Glenn, pag dumanin na sa Roma, pag dumanin na, may mga programa duman na inspire siya na kaya binago. Kaya I think for the next thing, araw na kani ang satuya. Congratulations to everyone, to all the Earth Forum and Expo participants, especially dito paglingawan. There will be speakers this afternoon, tomorrow, and Friday. Dagugunta po, and Saturday. Saro na dyan suhiyado ko, si Cedric Mataraman, and siyempre iba pang mga experts para i-remind kita kung ano ang pigisabi na climate change phenomenon and ano ang climate change adaptation and mitigation. Again, in closing, this is everyone's concern. We have a role to play, be it small or be it big. Kita gabos, yaon digde sa sarong Mother Earth, and we have really to protect it. Not only for this generation, but I tell you, for the next generation. Just mabalo sa endo gabos. Mabuhay tayo.
Thank you so much, our Governor of the Province of Albay, Honorable Noel E. Rosal, an international speaker on best practices on disaster risk reduction and a climate change adaptation LGU perspective, a multi-awarded local chief executive in good governance and transparency. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a warm round of applause to our Governor Noel E. Rosal.
Thank you so much, Governor Rosal, EVP Glenn Barcelon, and Ma'am Brenda Bayona Luxen. Thank you. Thank you so much po. Alright, so yan po mga tugang ang magkasunod na mga mensahe ninda Bishop Joel Bailon and Governor Noel E. Rosal. Mga tugang, apwera po sa mga nainot na mga personalidad na nagtaonin mensahe, magkaiba taman ngunyan ang saro sa mga mahigos na servidor as in listener po kanalbay. Saro sa sayang mayor na advokasya, iyo po ang agrikultura, kung kaya po ang sayang distrito, dakol ang mga nakaukod na magtanom. Let us all welcome for his message of support, Albay 3rd District Congressman Honorable Fernando Didi Cabrero.
To our most reverend Bishop of Legazpi, Bishop Joel C. Bailon, Governor Noel Rosal of the Province of Albay, Mayor G. Rosal of Legazpi City, Father Momoy, and Father June Barquez, and Madam Brenda Loxin, EBP Glenn Barcelon, BP Henry Maceda, and to everyone, kasi bago na pag-saro-saro naman na na-acknowledge, dahil naman ako mahaloy, ta aram ko madali na mag-alas 12. After hearing the keynote address of our beloved Bishop Joel C. Bailon and Governor Noel Rosal, as Congressman of the 3rd District of Albay, I reiterate my strong commitment in preserving our environment, preserving and protection of environment. I will continue in pushing my legislative action in establishing Mount Masaraga as protected landscape in the 3rd District of Albay. Kang big interview ako ka ito sa DZGB, nata ngaya big pupush mo na maging protected area ang Mount Masaraga. Parte niya ako ang Mount Masaraga is Pulangi. Ang Pulangi, grabe ang pagbaha. Dahil dawa niya ako magkaag ning dakulo ng mga dike, ang pagbaha, palangkaw ning palangkaw. Dahil niya ko, ang kabubuldan, kalbo na. Yan ang nabanggit ko sa bago ni Bishop. Grabe ang denudation kansatuyang mga forest. Diyan sa, mo, sa ginubatan, sa ligaw, dawa anong ikaag kang gobyerno ng mga flood controls. Bata nariparo ko, kan 2010, kaito ang pigakaag ng mga flood control, ang kantidad 10 milyones, 20 milyones. Halabauno na ang nagigibuan ng mga dike. Halagad sa munyan, billions of pesos na ang imbuelto. Tapos tabi, di man na garantiya, maraot, mabugtak ang gobyerno, di nang katapusan. Duman sa Panganiran River, sa ginuba, sa Piudran, siring man ang pangyari, ang pangyayari. Kalbo ang mga bulod, kaya di na mapupugulan ang pagpadagos kaaning pagdistroso kaaning mga pagbaha. Duma naman sa kadagatan ta. Samuya ang pigagibo mi duman, kapartner mi ang mga local chief executives. We protect the oceans. Didikaw, Burias Pass, kaypuhan talaga. Nalabanan ang illegal fishing. Te yun ang nakakadistroso kan sa tuyang kadagatan. Yaon tabi, ang pag-establish mi ning marine fish sanctuary. Padakulunta ang mga sira. Idagdag ko duman sa sinabi ni Bishop, the cause of the destruction of our environment, number one, is the economic needs of man. Pero sa totoo kayan, it is the greed of man ang nagiging cause kaning destruction kan sa tuyang forest. So kaya ako as legislator, my campaign in my to my constituents na dapat ma-address is food security. And then kaya sabi ko baga, magtanom, tinamaan kita ng dakulo ng mga bagyo, sunod-sunod, yaong paso pandemya. Ako tabi, sabi ko, tawa pa niya ako, pagtawang kamukang gobyerno ng mga relief goods, iyan niya ako, pangsaro o pangduwang aldaw man sa naiyan. Kaya ako niya ako, wala man akong relief, bako man ako local government unit, wala man akong budget, tuturoan ko niya ako kamo, magtanom, te iyon niya ako iyan ang masalbar. Halagad, kuya niya ako, bako sa naiyan, mga material na bagay, pati niya ako, ang moral values. Ang mga aki nindo, turuan nindo ng tamang pag-uugali. Takami niya ako, sa gobyerno, matupad kami kan samuya mga tungkulin, kan samuya mga trabaho. Kaya tabi, yan ang gusto kong ma-impart sa okasyon na ini, na magayunong tabi. Kaya congratulations, Madam Brenda Luxin, magayunong tabi ining Earth Hour nindo na iuman talaga ang kaypuhan na papanahon ang pigurustoryahan tadigdi bako naman tabi su presente kundi su futuro sumaabot ng panahon. Again, thank you DZGB. Happy anniversary. Thank you for having me invited in this occasion. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you so much, Albiter District Representative Honorable Fernando Didi Cabredo. And to award the Certificate of Appreciation with the token, we have once again our President, Ma'am Brenda Bayona Loxin, together with Executive Vice President, Sir Glenn J. Barcelona.
Mga tugang, abangan po niya itong mensahe kang saro sa mga senador kan Pilipinas. And after the short message, the senator, message of support of Dr. Perchito Avilino, the ARD of DOH will follow. Attorney Tin.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, expressing his support to our Earth Forum and Expo, we have the video message of Senator Win Gatchalian.
Marhay na aldaw sa lahat ng mga kalahok sa Environment, Agriculture, Resiliency, Tourism, and Health o Earth Forum and Expo. Binabato ko rin ng maligayang ika-64 na anibersaryo ang DZGBAM na pinamumunuan ni PBN Executive Vice President and Station Manager Glenn Barcelon. Lubos akong nakikisa sa inyong pagsusulong ng maaadikain upang mapangalagaan ang ating kalikasan sa pamamagitan ng paghahain ng mga panukala upang tugunan ang krisis pangklima. Mula pa noong tayo chairman ng Senate Committee on Energy, isa na sa mga advokasya ng inyong lingkod ang pagsusulong sa renewable energy para sa mas malinis na hangin. Ngayong 19th Congress, naghain tayo ng Senate Bill number 157 upang magtatag ng isang national energy policy para sa isang energy transition sa bansa. Sa isinusulong nating batas na Electric Vehicle Industry Development Act, inaasahan na tuloy-tuloy ang pag-usbong ng makabago at sustainable transportation sa bansa. Ilan lamang ito sa marami nating abukasiya tungo sa mas malinis, mas maaliwalas at mas ligtas na kapaligiran at kalikasan. Ito po si Senator Win Gatchalian, win tayong lahat.
Thank you so much, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian. Mga tugang, part of our Earth Forum and Expo is our advocacy on health. Ladies and gentlemen, let us all hear the messages of support from the Assistant Regional Director of the Department of Health, Assistant Regional Director, Dr. Percito Avellino.
Madam Loxin, Madam Rosal, Most Reverend Bailon, Father Momoy, Honorable Governor Rosal, Honorable Congressman Cabredo, Mr. Glenn Barcelon, sa gabus po na yaon digdi, ang Department of Health, on behalf kansatuyang regional director na si Dr. Ernie Vera, nagasuporta po at pigre-recognize and na-acknowledge ang gabos na aktibidades po tanganing ma-preserve ang buhay. Buhay po kang tao, buhay kang satuyang saru-saru sana na pigaapod na earth. Dakol na po ang nataram, ugto na po. Kaya ang sasabihon ko po, langbang saro sa tuya, alagaan ta ang satuyang palibot kan satuyang pagkatao. Kung lambang saro sa tuya, aalagaan ta ang satuyang pigtutukawan, pigtitindugan, pigtatrabahuan, pigrirespeto ta ang satuyang sadit na espasyo. Pag sararoon po yan, espasyo na po yan ang pag-apod mundo. So, all the best sa activity na ini. Magkaburunyog po kita, magsama-sama kita na i-preserve na po ang buhay kang tao, ang buhay kang mundo.
Thank you so much, Dr. Percito Avellino, Assistant Regional Director of the Department of Health, CHD Bicol. To award the Certificate of Appreciation and Token, our President, Ma'am Brenda Bayona Loxin, and the Executive Vice President, Glenn J. Barcelon. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have reached the conclusion of the opening ceremonies for PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated's Earth Forum and the Expo. Let us now lend our ears and listen to the overall project director of this jam-packed event. To give us the closing remarks, may we please call on stage the Executive Vice President of PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated and the concurrent station manager of DZGBAM, Mr. Glenn J. Barcelon.
Bishop Bong Bailon, Governor Noel Rosal, Mayor Geraldine Rosal, Congressman Didi Cabredo, Asagabos na niyon, Dr. Avellino, and to each and every one of you, dahil ko na po kamusaro-saroon, ta properly acknowledge naman po gabos kita and ang oras I have to give a short closing remarks. Inot na inot, sangaran po kan sa moyang istasyon, kan DZGB, na nagsisilibrar kang 64 taon. Minapaabot po kami, kidakulang pasasalamat sa saindong gabos, sa saindong pagsuporta as in partisipasyon sa satuyang Earth Forum and Expo. Tama po na nasambit ni Ma'am Brenda, buda ni Governor Rosal, na ito pong Expo is an expansion project kang dati ming pinagigibong partnership sa City Government of Legazpi. Kapag nagpipiesta ang Legazpi, nag-anibersaryo man po tabi ang DZGB, na iyo ang dating Agri-Aqua Fair. Napundo lang po ini dahil nagkaigong pandemya. Nagkataon po na nagduman kami ni BP Henry, buda na raw Ma'am Brenda, duman sa Amsterdam, nag-attend po kami kang International Broadcasting Conference, buda, diretso naman kami nagduman sa Rome. And saro po kang signifikante na sa muyang na-obserbaran duman, ito pong sa indang pagtataonin pagpapahalaga sa climate change adaptation. Kanagsakay po kami sa Etihad Airways, duman po sa TV screen niya, igod naman ki-promotional material ang sa indang airlines. And naglataw po duman na nagtaw o nagkuha kang sa kuyang atensyon, ito pong sa indang programa manungod sa climate change adaptation. Inot na inot, sabi ninda, by 2030, ang gabos nindang mga eroplano, day na magamit ki-fuel, day ng carbon dioxide emission. Panduwa, iga po sindang dinevelop na ikta-iktar yang forest, napiga po din ng Etihad Forest, na sabi nga ni Padre Momoy, the lung of the city, kung digdi sa Legazpi, sa indaman is the lung of the earth, tanganing igwang oxygen na magluwas duman sa mga kahoy na mga pinagtutanuman ninda. Panduwa, duman sa Amsterdam, kanag river cruise bagatabi kami duman, Gob, sabi mo ang Legazpi may similarity duman sa Amsterdam. We have so many things to learn from them. Itong sa indang river cruise, so sa indang bankero o itong nagpapadalagan kang sakayan, at the same time, siya naman ang tour guide. Sabi niya, by 2025 to 2030, ang sa indang mga makina, din na magamit yung mga gasolina, mga krudo. Electricity driven na yon. In compliance man tabi sa climate change adaptation. And na-notice mi tabi ni BP Henry, grabe ang pagpapahalaga ninda kang kalinigan sa environment. Natimpuhan mi, ikwang grupo ki nagtitest kang tubig duman sa mga salog, iiling ninda, pigme-measure ang pollution. And nga lason kami na itong bankero o tour guide, nagkuha siyang tubig duman sa mismong salog na pinagdadalaganan kang bangka. And pig-inom niya, pig-pahiling niya sa mo, na malinig ang sa indang tubig. Ininom niya talaga ito. And duman sa hotel, and sa mga restaurants, and mga function halls na dumanan mi, ang tubig duman na pig-inom, aling gripo mismo. So mahiling po nindo, ang grabing pagpapahalaga ninda sa environment. And saro kang na-notice mi po duman, itong mga bisiklita, ang mode of transportation, mahiling mo, very dominant, bisiklita yan. Ang sabi daa, ang populasyon kang Amsterdam, 800,000. Pero ang bisiklita, nasa 1.3 to 1.4. So arog kayan sinda, very friendly sa environment ang sa indang transportation. In fact, saro pa ka na-notice mi, itong sa indang mga sakayan, sa mga auto, sa radio ton sana, sa radit, bako darakulaon sa tuya, baka padarakulaan, adi, duman, pasaraditan, and then, powered by electricity. Duman sa mga kanto-kanto, iguan na duman, baga sa to, gasoline station, duman, nagkakargaman sindaki kuryente. So, very environment-friendly talaga. And, manonotice mo, grabe ang windmills sa inda. In terms of alternative energy, na very environment friendly. Windmills talaga ang duman, ang source of power duman. And sa mga harong na naihiling me, very dominant maobserbaran mo ang mga bubong anas may solar power, solar panel. So, mahiling mo man na economic environment friendly tabi yan. And siguro saro ini kang dapat maadalan ta na may problema kita sa energy problem sa Legazpi City and Albay, baka saro ini kang mag-alternatibo na pwede tang ma-advocate. So ngayon, ining mga naadalan ming ini na nahiling me, kang sarong aldaw, Sabado, nagduman kami sa ano, sa Muyami Magduman Bishop kay St. Francis of Assisi. Nagbala kami ni BP Henry na magpasyar duman. Tamuyamin magpangadye. Kaya lang, pag-abot mi sa Terminal Cantren, strike. So, wala makipagkakaiba sa to. Nag-i-restrike man duman. Warang biyay sa tren. So, day kami nadagos. Kaya, nagbalik kami sa dormitory mi kay Santa Rafaela. Nag-uristoryahan kaming dua na sa parte kang pag-istoryahan mi, ininganing agri-aquafair. And nag-reflect kami na parang na-inspire kami na mantang day kami nakaduman, nakabisita kay St. Francis, pero niyaon sa samuyang intensyon, narumduman mi na si St. Francis is the patron saint of ecology. Kaya duman nagtaririk sa istoryahan mi, and ito ang naging rason na na-inspire kami, and ito ang nagtulak sa muya na mabilog ining Earth Forum and Expo. Pagbili mi, ang inot ming dinuman, si Governor Noel Rosal. And as usual, pero may dayan nagsayo, ma, for so long a time, mayor yan, nag-gobernador, pag-abot sa DZGB, gabos kita, padaba man kita, lalo sa mga barangay captains. And of course, sa ladong ini, muyaming pasalamatan, lambang saro kamo, lambang saro sa Indo, and kada aldaw sa 4 days na ini, na-mention nga ni mayor, na igwa kitang mga forum. May mga kanya-kanyang topic po ini. Ngunya na hapon, ang sa tuyo mga guest speaker, Sara Dr. Cedric Daep, si may representative ang DNR, Environmental Management Bureau, and then so taga Energy Development Corporation, si Mr. Eduardo Jimenez, and si Miss Ann Marian Tan, ang Vice President for Merchandising kang LCC Group of Companies. Nang sa indang tema is Forum on Environment and Climate Change Adaptation. And every day, tomorrow naman, another topic, Forum on Environment, Tourism and Agricultural Advocacies on Climate Change na siguro po man in ni Father Mumoy, niya o man si Engineer Martin Reynoso, ma-present man siya kang about sa green environment. And of course, niya o man si Regional Director Herbie Aguas na ma- tukarman kang tema sa agritourism. And si Father Mumoy, ang sa iyang bagong project ngun yan, ining building community resiliency and livelihood opportunity through kawayan para sa kalikasan at kabuhayan. On the third day, sa October 21, igo kitang forum on the impact of climate change to agriculture and ways to adapt. Nyauman po dyan ang satuyang Provincial Agriculture Officer na si Ma'am Rose Biludo, and then ang satuyang City Agriculturist na si Ma'am Sheila Nas. And sabi ni Congressman Didi, sa sayang aki, and si Sheila, ipapa-join niya man po, tabi digdi, because naka-align kita sa mga programa ni Kong Didi sa 3rd District na agriculture. And matauman ki sa indang topic ang si Mrs. Salvacion and Jeric Garchitorena on herbal medicine. Ta accredited po siya kang ATI learning site. And sa October 22, gari naman ini ang samuyang pinaka-highlight kang anniversary, pero may inot po ang forum on DOH program in the new normal. Kay ba may po digdi si Ma'am Noemi Bron. And after that, yun na po ining Senior Citizens Health and Wellness Day. So, sa giraray, salamaton po sa Indo Gabos, and I now formally open the Earth Forum and Expo. Magpasyar po kita sa mga booth dyan sa tuwing likodan. Salamat po sa Indo Gabos.
Thank you so much, Executive Vice President of PBN Broadcasting Network Incorporated and the Concurrent Station Manager of DZGB AM, Mr. Glenn J. Barcelona. So ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our opening ceremonies for our Earth Forum and Expo. May we please call our honorable guests and our VIPs to please come up the stage for our photo ops. Once thank again, you. Please, our VIPs. So, we would like to acknowledge the presence of Ms. Marian Ali Santan, a VP Merchandising LCC Supermarket. She will be one of our speakers later for LCC's Best Environmental Practices, a private response to Laudato Si.
Alright, sabagan po mga tugang dyan na hapon, ang sa toyang forum 1:30 in the afternoon, digdi po sa Yala Malls Legazpi, live din sa DZGB and Facebook page of DZGB. Ang sa toyang forum on sustainable development, climate change adaptation. Ang magkakaibata po dyan, sinda Dr. Cedric Daeb Canapsemo, Engineer Maria Socorro Abo, Regional Director EMB o Environment Management Bureau on the assessment on the implementation of RA 9003 in its impact on climate change adaptation where we are now. And we have Mr. Eduardo Jimenez, Head Corporate Relations, Bachmann Energy Development Corporation. Ipipresentar niya po ang Exploring Nature-Based Solutions for Ecosystem-Based Watershed Management Towards Agricultural Productivity. And we have Ms. Marian Alison Tan, VP for Merchandising LCC Supermarket. Ipipresent niya po ang LCC Best Environmental Practices, a private response to Laudato Si.
Mga tugang, ang nangyari mo niya na aga, sa tuya pa lang po yan na opening ceremonies for our Earth Forum and Expo. At dyan na hapon, dakol pa po kitang, igwa pa po kitang forum. And ining Earth Forum and Expo, sagkod po ining Oktubre 22, 2022. So abangan po ang mga masunod na samuyang event.
Yes, pwede kong maghapot sa forum dyan na hapon with Attorney Christine and yours truly. Para po sa tuyang panel discussion, and we have 6 or 7 panel reactors invited for the discussion, mga tugang on climate change and sustainable development.
Once again, we would like to thank our sponsors, Provincial Government of Albay, City Government of Legazpi, Energy Development Corporation through District Representative Fernando Didi Cabredo, Ayala Malls Legazpi, Department of Tourism Region 5, Good Found Cement Factory,
Aral Musica at Lampara, thank you so much, LCC Food Garden, LCC Concourse, New Blossoms Catering Services, Robert James Exhibit Masters Corporation,
Legazpi City Fiesta Committee Chairman Councilor Albarizo, JHRX Food Products and Catering Services, Liga ng Mga Barangay Legazpi Chapter, Department of Health Center for Health Development Bicol, Globe Telecom Ayala, J2K Manpower and Allied Services, Pitmaster Foundation, and of course our exhibitors here at Ayala Malls Legazpi, DOH Region 5 Booths Number 1 and 5, Laudato Si Farm, Booth Number 2 and 6, Department of Tourism Region 5, Booth Number 4.
Alright, we have OCNR, Legazpi Number 8, Provincial Agriculture's Office, madami pong booth yan pwedeng puntahan, Agriculture's Office, Joboken Enterprises, and Puri, Hosanna, tama ba ang pagkunansyan, Attorney? Travel and Tours.
Hosanna, yeah. Travel and Tours. Okay. And we also have EDC booth number 3 and 7.
Yan. So mga pampalaha, so mga punong barangay and the other visitors, may i-distribute kong lunch nyo yan. Thank you so much. Nahiling ko si Kagawad Hao and Kagawad Ato Valladolid. Thank you so much. And Kagawad JP, kumbresan ko na ang Palunso de Legazpi. And we have the punong barangays and other guests po and visitors, may igwa po kita ki lunch na i-distribute nyo yan para po sa Endo Gabos. Attorney?
Salamaton po, mag-irilingan kita dyan na hapon para sa satuyang forum, digdi sa Earth Forum and Expo. This is Christine Longabella.
And po si Henry M., ang lalaking hindi inuwaga. See you this afternoon. Thank you so much po. Maray na hapon sa Endo Gabos.
Sa selebrasyon kani ka 64 taon na anibersaryo kan DZGB sa taho kan pangapodan para sa pagmakulog sa satuyang common home na iyoan kinaban pag-adaptar sa pagbabago kan klima asin pandemyang COVID-19 sa muyang ipresentar at Earth Forum and Expo. Hatod sa indo kan Provincial Government of Albay, Governor Noel E. Rosal, City Government of Legazpi, Mayor Geraldine Rosal, asin Energy Development Corporation or EDC. Inimay temang Sustainable Development in Light of Laudato Si, Climate Change Adaptation and COVID-19 Pandemic. Maghiling asin magpartisipar sa diskusyon, asin aramon kung paano kita makakakontribuir sa implementasyon kan sustainable solusyon para makamtan ang kamauatan na makasimbag sa pangapodan ni Pope Francis to care for our common home. Tampok ang mga matitibay na leader sa aspeto ng environment, agriculture, resiliency, tourism and health, or earth, para ihiras ang sa indang kaaraman at sinexperyensya para sa sustainable paghiro sa panghinaba na pangapodan na masolusyonan ng pagtios, proteksyon sa satuyang pinag-iistara na kapalibutan. Maghiriligan kita sa Oktubre 19 sa Good22 sa Ayala Malls, Legazpi para sa Earth Forum asin aramon kung paano kita makakatabang bilang syudadano sa pagmakulog asin protehiran ang padagos sa pagbabago kan klima ning kinaban. An Earth Forum, madadangog, simulcast over DZGBAM, DZGB News Online Facebook page, DZGB Live Up, as in YouTube channel.